The new volume modeling workflow in Cinema 4D Release 20 makes it really easy to create complex organic models simply by combining basic shapes. So we're going to build out this gummy bear using nothing but Cinema 4D primitives, and we'll start by adding a volume builder object. Now we need to define the basic shape for our volume, and we can do that by adding Cinema 4D objects, either by dragging them directly into the objects list or by making the objects a child of the volume builder. So here we have some basic cubes and spheres to form the shape of our gummy bear, and we'll drag them into the volume builder, and you can see that the representation here in the view has changed. And that's because now, rather than viewing the polygons, we're viewing the voxels or 3D pixels that these shapes have formed. And you can see that all of those shapes are combined together here using a union type of Boolean mode. So what we have here is basically a better Boolean. Now, right now the representation is pretty rough, and that's because the voxel size, the resolution of the grid, is pretty big. It's 10 centimeters. If we bring this down to 2 centimeters, you'll see that we get a much more accurate representation of our gummy bear. Now, all of these objects are creating a single form, but in order to make things look more unified, I'm going to add a smooth layer on top of everything. And you can see how that just smooths everything out and instantly begins to make this look like the gummy bear. Now, the next major aspect of the gummy bear that we need are some ears. So for that, I'm just going to add a torus object. I'm going to go ahead and set the orientation here to plus Z, and we'll scale the torus down quite a bit. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and move it up here and add a symmetry object so that we can get two ears. We'll go ahead and move the torus out, and you can see how now we have two ears on top of our gummy bear. It looks like our torus is still a little big, so we'll bring the scale down a bit more. And I'm going to also increase the pipe radius here in the attributes so that we have something that looks like this. Now, again, I can name this ears and drag it under the volume builder in order to make it a part of our gummy bear object. Now, if we look in the volume builder, you can see that it's unifying with the object, but it's not underneath that smooth layer. So we're not getting the smoothing that we want. We can simply drag it underneath the smooth layer. And now you can see that we have some nice ears for the gummy bear. And again, everything stays live all the time, so we can continue to tweak this and get the ears looking just like we want. Well, let's go ahead and continue with the face of the gummy bear. Up to now, we've only combined objects, but we can subtract objects as well. Here I have a couple of spheres in a symmetry object to create the eyes. We'll drag those underneath the volume builder. And in the volume builder here, we want to go ahead and change the mode from union to subtract. And now you can see that we're creating some indentations for the eyes of the gummy bear. We'll go ahead and add a nose and a mouth as well. And you may have noticed that I'm not smoothing the facial elements. If I drop this smooth layer on top of everything, we really lose all detail in the face. But you can combine multiple smoothing layers at any point in the stack you want. So I'm going to add another smoothing layer and put it at the very top of the stack. And rather than using the Gaussian smoothing, I'm going to actually apply one of the less destructive smoothing methods. So I like using mean curvature or Laplacian flow. And of course, you can further refine this by changing the iterations and also adjusting which filter is being used. In fact, there's tons of power here. You can even use the new fields feature in order to attenuate the smoothing. And there'll be a lot of Cineversity tutorials that get into more detail with how all of this works. For now, let's go ahead and continue. The last thing I want to do on the gummy bear is actually cut out the back and bottom so that it looks like it came out of a candy form. And so for that, I'm going to add a cube here to create that shape of that form. We want to go ahead and add a fillet on this so that things can be a bit rounded. Going to get this roughly into place and then rename this cut form and drag it under the volume builder. Now, what I want to use here is the intersect Boolean mode so that we only get the voxels that are in both the cube cut form space as well as the body. That's a bit of a harsh transition. It's what I was looking for, but it's a bit harsh. So what we'll do is move it underneath the smoothing layer. First, I'm going to go ahead and raise the cut form a little bit here, and we're going to move it underneath the smoothing layer so that the transition there smooths out really nicely. So this is our basic gummy bear, but if we hit the render button, you'll notice that we actually don't have an object yet. This is just a voxel representation. So in order to render this, what we need to do is mesh it. And we do that simply by dragging the volume builder as a child of a volume mesher object. Now you can see that what we have here is a polygon object. In fact, if I go into the grow shading with lines mode, you'll see that we have a nice evenly distributed quad mesh. And it's a rather dense mesh, but it's also perfect to begin sculpting additional details with Cinema 4D sculpting toolset. However, if you do want to simplify this mesh, you can simply adjust the adaptive percentage. Now, one of the unique aspects of voxels is that they make it really easy to erode or dilate your objects. So we can increase and make this gummy bear a little fatter, or we can reduce the voxel range threshold and actually erode him a little bit. There's a lot of flexibility here. And in fact, we can use the power of Cinema 4D to gain even more flexibility. Let's go ahead and add a cylinder here. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the Z axis, and I'm gonna put it into a cloner object. I'm gonna use a radial arrangement here, and we'll just increase the size of this as well as the number of cylinders. And what I'm basically doing is creating a crude representation here of a mouth with some teeth. I'm just going to put a sphere here to form the center of the mouth. And I'm going to group all of this together, and we'll name it mouth. And we can drag that underneath our volume builder and put this into the subtract mode. And basically what we can do is eat away at our gummy bear. We can, of course, continue to modify this with fields and effectors. You can control the reshaping of things with fields and effectors. Again, this is a whole new world for Cinema 4D, and we're going to have a ton of Cineversity tutorials that get into more detail. For now, though, take a bite out of your own deadlines and explore the Volume Builder and its capability to easily create complex models simply by creating basic shapes. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you're excited about the Volume Builder in Cinema 4D Release 20, please like and share this video, and make sure to check out our entire Cineversity playlist on new features in Cinema 4D Release 20.